I wanted you to see an article. I thought it was interesting. I'm going to try and set it up for you. So it says, Zillow stops buying houses. What does this mean? And what will other will other iBuyers follow suit? So I don't know if you know this, but there's like OfferPad, there's Zillow, and there's a couple others. And what they'll do is they'll for some reason, some sellers are like, nobody's going to buy my house because it needs some work or something like that. And so what an iBuyer does is they say, well, a nice trick is they say, well, your house is worth this much. And that normally gets you in the door. And then they walk through the house and they say, you need to fix this, 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 and this. But you're not going to want to do that. So here's our offer and we'll pay you cash and we'll close in 30 days or maybe they'll even close sooner. And then what they'll do is they'll go in and they'll fix up the house and then they'll list it for more. It's kind of like a fix and flip, except, and it's not much different than like we have corporate housing. And so what that is basically is, so say you're an executive, you move, you sell your house to the third party relocation company, and then the third party relocation company sells the house on your behalf so that you can go buy another one. It's sort of like that. But what this article is interesting about is number one, it says that they're no longer buying houses. We're in October and they're saying that they're not buying it because of they're operating in a labor and supply constrained economy inside a competitive real estate market, especially in the construction, renovation, and closing spaces. Okay. So it says we now have an operational backlog for renovations and closings. Pausing new contracts will enable us to focus on sellers already under contract and with us and our current home inventory. So they're saying, hey, we're not going to buy any more houses this year. And then that's Zillow offers. And then, so you got to understand millions and millions of dollars behind Zillow right now. Okay. So they have no problems with cash. They're not going to go bankrupt. They're just absolutely fine. Then there's Open Door. That's another iBuyer. And then Redfin also does it they have Redfin now. The two other companies, the big ones that we just mentioned, they're still buying houses. But what I wanted to go over with you guys is we've seen in the used car market that you have these intermediaries now. You have like Carvana, and I don't know the other ones, but there's like three or four. And what they'll do is they come in and literally agree to, I think as long as the car is less than 10 years old, they'll set up the process to buy your car. Okay. And then they hold the car and then they sell it to someone else. But there's all kinds of money behind Carvana. And I have wondered, are these companies taking these homes just like they're taking cars and basically inventorying them? So taking up all the inventory, and is that what's causing our problems with housing? Is that what's causing our problems with automotive sales? It's not the BlackRocks of the world that are buying, the institutional investors buying up homes and keeping them, in my opinion. And I don't know the answer on this one, but I feel like if you have all these companies that can take up the inventory and just buy houses, and they'll get a return on their investment, but they've got so much money behind them. If they lose on one or 10 houses, they're going to be fine. Okay. But if they've got like this article says they've got a backlog of homes that they can't get to right now that they need to fix up. And this is just one of them. The other two say they're fine. But with that backlog of homes, that's inventory. So, like if you look at Afton, 63123 zip code, in a typical year, let's just say there's 300 homes sold in the zip code. It may be more, maybe less, but just for this example, let's say there's 300 sold homes. So when you have iBuyers come in, and let's just say they buy 100 of the homes, they've got those in inventory. Now you're left with 200 homes for everybody else to fight over. It changes the dynamics of the marketplace. Because you no longer have a single family home owner selling to a single family home buyer. You have an institution with nearly limitless cash able to buy a home and sit on it for as long as they need to turn a profit. And even if they don't turn a profit, they're going to, you know, they're fine on volume. Now, are they taking 100 homes in a zip code? No. But they're not the only ones. There's three other ones. There's three other. So there's a lot of inventory being taken up. And I believe that this could be one of the reasons why the housing market is so terrible for buyers, is because the inventory is being taken up. Doesn't mean that it's not going to come back. I mean, all those houses are going to come back on the market. It's just the issue of taking up the inventory. If you have less supply with a tremendous amount of demand, you're going to have a problem. And I feel like that's, you know, that's what this could be. I don't know. I have no basis from which to no numbers from which to pull from. I'm just saying this could be an issue. Now, you say, well, okay, now that you've identified an issue, is there a way to stop it? I don't know. I haven't gotten that far. Just know that the market is a little bit unnatural in a sense, and this may be a reason why.